بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. رمضان مبارك. I want to thank all the supporters of DeanStream and also of Sendala. These are two organizations that are solely for spreading Islamic tradition and Islamic knowledge. Alhamdulillah, all of the income that comes from these endeavors goes back into the actual work. Nobody's taking any salary or making money from these things. I think a lot of people are under some misconceptions about that. This is all volunteer work from the people on that end. And so I just want to thank everybody that's been supportive, because the more people that help us, the more that we can do. And we would like to do a lot more. And really, this is merely a material matter for us. We have a lot of ideas, a lot of projects that we want to do. Sendala, we've been working on the Zaytuna curriculum series, and we've got a few books that are coming up very shortly. Alhamdulillah, there's going to be out for people, make them available. And also the DeanStream, we really want to increase the content. There's a lot of things that we would like to do, and inshallah in the future you're going to see more. We are very appreciative of the people that have been supporting us, and so really this is just a shout out to all of you. Thank you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. This is an extraordinary time. It's an unprecedented time. All of us are grappling with what's happening. I likened it to God putting the entire planet under house arrest. In a lot of ways, the lifestyles that people have been living have been so extravagant and in many places, and certainly here in the United States and in Western Europe, I think the levels of lifestyle, the amount of traffic, the extraordinary stress and tension involved in just an average day in the life of an average person in these countries is quite overwhelming. And for that reason, this is an extraordinary opportunity for people to really think about what they're doing with their lives. It's an amazing testimony to the extraordinary ability of this planet to recuperate when we're seeing so many areas that are flourishing now because of the cessation of human activity. I mean, it's quite extraordinary. But it's also a time for us as individuals to think about what we're doing here, the meaning of our lives, how we spend our time, because I think a lot of people are being confronted with the fact that they really don't know how to spend their time, especially when they have a lot of it. You can only watch so many programs. You can only watch so many films. At a certain point, you're going to have to ask yourself some fundamental questions about what are you doing here? What's your purpose? And how can you make more out of this extraordinary gift, the opportunity that we've been afforded for this very short time, which the extent of it is maybe 100 years maximum, but for most people it's going to be less than that. But it's an extraordinary opportunity, and one of the most important things, if not the single most important thing in the human endeavor, is to increase our understanding. And one of the main reasons for doing that is to understand who created us, why we were created, for what purpose, and then where we're going. These are all things that the Quran explores in depth and gives us stunning answers to the most difficult questions that have perplexed human beings since time immemorial. So it's an extraordinary opportunity, Ramadan, to get back to the Quran and the message of the Quran and the reminder of the Quran. The Quran is a dhikr. It's a reminder. Allah is ghafir. He forgives the sins. Allah is al-ghafur. He forgives not just the sins, but the immense quantities of sins. And He's al-ghafar. He's oft forgiving. It's a continuous process. And so Ramadan is a time to turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to reconnect with the Book of Allah. For some people, Ramadan is like any other month in terms of their practice. Certainly for the Prophet ﷺ, the Prophet's practice did not increase in Ramadan with the exception of charity. But his night prayers, his recitation of Quran, all of these things. This is his want during throughout the year, but he did become more charitable during the month of Ramadan, and he was the most charitable of men. But that is just because of the barakah of the time, the blessing of the time. It's an incredible time to gain nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of you. Again, I just really want to thank you for supporting this organization. I especially want to thank Dr. Aisha Subhani for the immense work that she's done to create this extraordinary mechanism for spreading this knowledge. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all the work that she's done and the people that work with her team. So, alhamdulillah, we're very grateful.